In this video, you will learn how to display the content of a file. Here you will learn the cat command, the less command, and the tail command, and the head command. Let us see how this is used in the terminal. Now, we will make use of names.txt. You remember, we copied the file called names.txt into lesson 1. We can confirm that by listing the contents of this directory recursively. So let us say move names.txt to where it belongs. It was here in the beginning. If I list this, we have names.txt. If I list the contents of lesson 1, we don't have names.txt there. To see what names.txt contains, we use the cat command. Cat and an argument. You cannot use cat without something. If you want to see, you have to see something. If you hit enter, then cat is waiting for you to type. If I type my name, it spits my name. So I control C to stop that. That is not desired. So cat names.txt. This is the content of names.txt. It is a file that contains 100 names that I downloaded from the internet. I organized them from 1 to 100. So cat spits out all the contents of the file, irrespective of how big it is. It tries to display everything. But there's another way to view the contents of a file in a page-like manner. This one, we use the less command. Less and the name of the file, names.txt. This is nice. If I zoom my terminal, this number will change. It tries to display as much as I can see on the screen. So if you hit the arrow down button of your keyboard, it tries to go one line at a time. If you hit the page down button, you give next page, next page, next page, next page, next page, and so forth. Next page, next page. And when it's the end, it tells you the end. This is how the less command is used. You press the Q button on your keyboard. Q as in queen. And it goes out. What if we want to see the last name or the last line of the file or the last 5 lines? This could be a file that contains the result of a class. You want to see the people who did not perform well. You say tail and the name of the file, it will try to display the last 10. You see, it gives you the last 10 and ends there. What if you want to see the last 5 or the last 3? You say tail, give me line number that is minus n, and you put 5. For example, I want to see the last 5. Then you see it. Oh, I did not put the name of the file. I do these errors all the time. Names.txt. And we see that we have the last 5. But if you want to see the top 5, for example, or the top 10, you just put head, the name of the file, names, without specifying any number of lines, it gives you the first 10. Here you see that, the first 10 names. If I want to see the top 3 names, what do you think that command would be? Yeah, of course, minus n and 3, the name of the file, poop, we have the 3 there. This is how you see the content of a file. We will also learn how to append content to the file. Now you know that the last part of the file, the last entry of this file is entry number 100, Zachary. Let me append my name on this file. I'm not sure my name is there. So to append that, you use the echo, my name, Bernard Longo, and I redirect this to a file, names.txt. This will append this content at the end of the file. I want to put 101. So it also looks beautiful like the others. Now if I put tail names, you see my name there, number 101, Bernard Longhorn. If I want to override this file, or I want to replace the content of this file with just my name, you use one of these greater than. This replaces all the contents of the file with whatever I write here. If you, now I can even cut because I know that the file is not big. That's all. All the other names are being replaced by this, by my name that I wrote here. So you should be very careful when using this redirect. If you use the double greater than, then you are appending content at the end of the file. If you use just one, know that you are replacing the content of that file. They say to whom more is given, more is expected.